According to a recent police report of 2022, a total of 4,534 people died in road crashes in the country, which is about 12 Ugandans dying every day in road crashes. Out of these, the Albertine region is recording the highest fatal rates per road crash attributed to excitement over speeding, driving vehicles and motorcycles under dangerous mechanical conditions, among others.
From 2019 to 2020, crashes have increased by 16% in this region. In 2020 to 2021, just over 20% as well. So it means where you had 10, you had an additional 2 the next year. There were 100, you had an additional about 20 crashes.
These accidents are majorly happening on Hoima Kaisotonya Road, Hoima Chenjojo Road, Hoima Masindi Road, and Masindi Kiriandongo Road.
People have been saying that the roads are bad. Now government has improved the what? The roads. Now why is it that the accidents are increasing? If we say the roads are the major contributory factors, the excitement of the people using the roads.
Godwin Arinaitwe, the Albertine Region Traffic Officer, has noted that the region has registered a number of fatal accidents. The districts with the highest fatalities are Chikuba District, followed by Bulisa, Hoima, Chiriandongo, and Masindi.
And now the biggest problem which we are receiving right now, our border people, our brothers there, who are riding without insurance. I've already given one scenario where I myself has participated. It is still happening, and it's going to continue happening if we don't put our hands together.
James Katunguka, the senior road safety officer at the Ministry of Works, notes that with the rampant road crashes, the region and the country are being affected both economically and socially, something that needs to be treated as an emergency.
We find that in Uganda we are losing almost 4.4 trillion, which is about 5% of our GDP. Then the indirect cost, the pain, grief, and suffering, the poverty, the orphanage, it is completely unbearable.
Okwesanga, a tax is supposed to be around
you. Corrupt traffic officers contribute to road accidents. You find a 14-passenger taxi carrying more than 20 passengers. When a traffic officer stops it, he just collects money and allows the vehicle to continue on its journey. Some of the border riders use drugs, which clouds their judgment on the roads. They put drugs under their tongues. Where did Kawunye Mugo? They should reinstate it.
We salute the traffic officials. The work that they do is really very good. And even here in Uganda, they guide us on road very much. But sometimes you also meet them on the border, not having helmets. But they are going to enforce. They are putting on helmets, but they themselves do not have helmets.
Report by Ambrose Nwagaba Katoto for the news.